Any failure of the current supply does not affect the position of the contacts, thus retaining the electrical memory of the logic circuit. To delatch the contacts, the reset coil must be energized when water level goes above normal. Thus, two separate input signals are required for the operation of the electrical reset relay from the device to be monitored. One input signal is to energize the operating coil and the other one to energize the reset coil if reset operation is required. Thus, even if the supply to the operating coil fails, the contacts retain their position since reset coil is unenergized. Misleading of logic circuits is thus prevented. In this type of relay, there is one main drawback. If the monitored device fails due to some problem, the contacts of the monitoring relay must reset. But due to primary device circuit failure, the resetting coil will not get power to get energized. Hence, contacts of the relay will not reset. This is lesser of the two evils since failure to operate is more troublesome than failure to reset. This problem is unavoidable until a separate supply is provided for the reset coil to reset. Thus, you have learnt about electrical reset relays.